Tesla S&P developers. Given the variety of content that you can now find with the S&P Business Accelerator Hub, there is a need to have a special section in the website where you can focus on other content relevant to a specific persona. Recently, the concept of domains was introduced in the S&P Business Accelerator Hub. Each domain represents a distinct area of focus. At the moment, there are two sections, integration and S&P Build. Make sure to check them out. New regions are available where you can deploy your advanced event mesh brokers. The availability differs depending on the infrastructure as a service provider where you want to deploy it. Have a look on the website on all the regions available. Last, but certainly not least, the OpenSAP course, Modernized Integration with SAP Integration Suite, is on its third week. The content is great, and if you check out the download section for each week, you can find some additional exercises, which will grant you access to test systems and will guide you with while you get familiar with the tools and get some hands-on experience. I'm including the links to all the content in the description below.
Are you looking to gain seamless access to your mission-critical business data, no matter where it resides? Join us this fall at SAP TechEd in the Data and Analytics track, which is dedicated to helping you build solutions that give purpose to your data and help simplify your data landscape. Our track touches three important areas: strategic decision-making through planning and analytics, highlighting SAP Analytics Cloud. Secondly, simplifying the data landscape with the Business Data Fabric. Here, the big stars are SAP DataSphere and SAP's new Open Data Ecosystem, as well as SAP Master Data Governance. And last but not least, building innovative business applications with database services with a focus on SAP HANA Cloud. Ready to take your business data to the next level? Join me and my team at SAP TechEd and visit us in the Data and Analytics track. See you in November.
Hi, everyone, and welcome to the SAP Developer News. I have a couple of quick news items for you today. First, the September release of the SAP Cloud Application Programming Model is out now. There are a couple of very interesting updates regarding PostgreSQL, the CDS language and the CDS compiler, as well as for the specific implementations of Java and Node.js. Also, there's a continuous influence session currently running, so you can propose new requests for features in CAP and shape the future of the programming model. That's pretty cool. The second news item I have for you today is the new edition of the SAP UI5 Roadmap Explorer. So definitely check it out if you're interested in UI5. You can check the current status, for example, of the modular bootstrap and everything else the team is currently working on. See you. Bye.
SAP DataSphere is our strategic target solution for all data warehouse and data management use cases in the public cloud. If you're considering what your path from the classic on-prem SAP BW to SAP DataSphere should look like, then Dominic Kurtz published a blog post, BW Move, Explore Your Modernization Options. To help you, Dominic presents different paths you may take to transition your data warehouses from the on-prem to the cloud, 5 options to consider and their prerequisites, a comparison of the Big Bang approach to the gradual transition, and what complexity drivers you should take into consideration. If you prefer listening to reading, then please check recordings of 2 Oktoberfest presentations, BW Move Explore Your Modernization Options with Dominic, and Conversion Deep Dive to SAP DataSphere with Dennis Osse. And by the way, should you attend SAP TechEd in Bengaluru next month, then do not miss a dedicated session on this topic. And don't forget to stop by the developer garage to discuss how to gain experience with SAP DataSphere if the product is new for you.